In this video, I'm going to give you a super simple overview of how you can use Asana to basically organize your life. I've been using Asana for about a year now, and for me as a solopreneur, it has been super helpful in helping me get tasks done so that I can make the money that I need to make. It's also really helpful to me in helping me track my own personal habits. And so, whatever it is that you want to organize, Asana really is a great tool. And so, if you're completely new to the tool, then this video is for you. All right, so the first thing that you want to go going to want to do with Asana, and let me mention also that Asana is available both as a tool that you can use in a browser on the internet, like I'm using it right here, or you can use it on your cell phone or mobile device as an app. And so you can definitely track this, your progress or track your projects throughout the entire day. All right, so once you've created your project, all right, if you're using the desktop version, you're going to go into new. And in new, there are a few things that you can do. You can either create a task, a project, or a conversation. A task is simply something that you want to be able to just check off really quickly. If you have something more elaborate that has multiple steps, you may want to create a project for that. And then if you're going to be working with a team, this is where you can create a conversation. In this video, I'm not going to be talking about conversations. I will talk about it in another video where I talk about teams and Asana. But I will talk about task and project. So, like I said, with a task, it's just something that you're doing and then checking off. I love it if you can organize things into projects. And so let's go ahead and create a new project. All right, and let's call it book project. All right, and there are a few ways that you can organize your project. You can organize them as a list or as a board that you can move sticky notes around on. All right, it really is up to you. I tend to like the list format. So let's create the project. I'll say, okay, so now that we've created the project, we're going to add some tasks, okay? The very first one we're going to add, and so as you can see, when I hit that, we had this dialog box open, and so we're just going to put in here, complete the first draft, okay? Then we are going to put a due date on that, April 30th. We're going to put a description. This needs to be finished by April 30th. You can definitely also attach any files you may have. Maybe as you're writing this book, there are pertinent files that you want to be able to remember. You can do those attachments right here. You can certainly give it a thumbs up if this was a team project. You can copy the task link and share it with somebody else. So there are a few things that you can do. All right, and so once you've created that, you don't need to do anything. It's confusing because sometimes you can be tempted to hit this and mark as complete, but because we haven't completed it, it's important that we don't mark it as complete. All right, and then we can go ahead and add another task. All right, so I'm going to do this behind the scenes and then show you the finished product. And so I'm coming to the end of the tasks for this particular project. So we're just going to publish this book eventually on Amazon and put a due date for that at May 30th. Let's do that again. All right. And so now we have our tasks within our project. You can actually view this on a calendar as well. And so you'll be able to open up a calendar and take a look at the dates that these are due so that you can get an overview of when things are due. If you had, like I said, if you had people on this particular project, all right, or you wanted to add people, you could go right here to share, and then you would be asked to go ahead and share the emails of people that you want to be notified every time this is ready for you to update. All right, and so definitely this is something that you could work on with a team. If there are any files that you want to include in here, like I showed you earlier, you could maybe these are general forms that apply to everything regarding the project. You could definitely upload your files over here as well. And so really that is a general overview of what you can do with Asana as a very basic user. You can create a project, you can create tasks, and then you can put due dates and ensure share it with other people. To take a look at your different projects and tasks, you can come on here to the right hand side of your dashboard, or you can go into My Tasks and then look at the home page. You can go and then, you know, take a look at those, at the ones that are due today. You could also look at ones that are upcoming and then toggle them. And then you could go into home, and then over here you would get an overview of everything that you have going on, which includes your tasks that are due soon, as well as the different projects that you have created. All right, so that is how you can use Asana as a basic beginner.